Here we're going to use the steady state approximation for this overall reaction of two molecules of A reacting with a molecule B to make the compound A2B. It's a reversible reaction. And we have a rate expression that we want to compare to what we would obtain from the steady state approximation, where we're going to apply that steady state approximation to a sequence of elementary steps. So the first step in that sequence is a molecule of A reacting with a molecule B to form some reactive intermediate. So we'll call it AB star to indicate the reactive intermediate. Reversible reactions, the K's indicate the rate constant for the four reaction, K1, reverse reaction K minus one. And then the second step, this reactive intermediate reacts with another A molecule to make our final product A2B. So if we add these two elementary steps together, then we get our overall reaction and the react intermediate disappears. It's only present in low concentrations. This is because it's very reactive. And so we'll use that to apply the steady state approximation because it's present in low concentration. Steady state approximation assumes it quickly builds up to a steady state concentration and the derivative of that concentration with respect to time is equal to zero. So the steady state approximation then is this derivative concentration with respect to time equals zero. Because these are elementary steps, we can write down the rate of each of those steps. And so we can write down steps where we make or use up this reactive intermediate. And so in the first four reaction, K1 times the concentration of A and concentration of B. So use parentheses to indicate concentrations. That's the rate that we're forming the reactive intermediate, so it's positive. We're using it up in the reverse step, and so the concentration reactive intermediate, and then we use it up in the second step, so K2, concentration reactive intermediate, and the concentration of A, and then we form it in the last step, the concentration of A2B. We can solve this equation just by rearrangement to get the concentration of AB star, which is not something we can measure, in terms of our measurable concentrations, namely concentration of A, concentration of B, and concentration of A2B. And so this is the concentration of the reactive intermediate that we get from applying the steady state approximation. Then we want to get the rate that we form, because this is what we measure, the rate that we form A2B. Well, that's the rate of the second reaction. So K2, concentration of reactive intermediate, concentration of A is the rate that we're forming it. And of course, the reverse reaction means we're using it up. And so this is the net rate that we're making A2B. And so what we want to do is substitute this concentration here and then do the simplification to get a rate expression. So let me pause and write out that substitution. So here we have the rate expression. It looks relatively complicated, but now we're going to make a simplification because the way we make measurements, often the concentration of our product is low to make the measurements easier when we make kinetic measurements. So this term we're going to say is small because A to B concentration is small. And this is a function of how we make the measurements. So then the rate that we make our product becomes this expression here. And notice this expression is the same form as our experimental rate expression. Doesn't mean this is the correct mechanism that we picked, but at least as a mechanism is consistent. And we've used the steady state approximation to determine what the rate expression would look like for the mechanism that we've chosen.